Let's explore Ethereum Decentralized Finance. What is DeFi? DeFi is an acronym for Decentralized Finance. Decentralized Finance is a new financial system that is becoming more and more popular. The main benefit of DeFi is that it allows swapping, lending, or borrowing without intermediates or third parties. Let's take a DeFi example of decentralized exchange like ErgoDex, SundaeSwap, or Uniswap on Ethereum. When a wallet owner wants to exchange his asset from one currency to another, DeFi protocol helps to make the swapping. The beauty of swapping is that two users can interact without a third party in a trustless environment. Another DeFi example is lending and borrowing. Lending for interest is a 5,000 years old of business started in Middle East civilizations. Let's take an example of a bank. Lenders are depositing money to the bank to lend money to borrowers. Bank takes the most of the interest generated by the loan. In a DeFi, a bank is replaced with decentralized protocol to which depositors can deposit crypto assets. On the other side, the borrower can borrow the assets paying interest directly to the depositor. According to DeFi Pulse, in November 2021, there is $105 billion USD locked in DeFi projects. Most of it's on Ethereum blockchain. However, Ethereum blockchain has experienced more than a few exploits when hackers stole a lot of money from innocent users. Let's take a look into a couple of them. Poly network exploit. Poly network works by facilitating exchange between several blockchains as users trade one cryptocurrency for another, such as trading Bitcoin for Ether. A person found a vulnerability in contract calls that allowed to transfer over 600 million in crypto assets to hackers' wallets. Cream Finance exploit. Cream Finance was hacked not only once. The most recent hack allowed to steal $130 million in crypto assets. The hacker was able to take advantage of a pricing vulnerability by repeatedly lending and borrowing flash loan funds across two addresses. After accumulating collateralized USD, the price of underlying USD token was manipulated in order to effectively double the value of the collateral owned by the attacker. Finally, using the now overvalued collateral, the attacker drained Cream's lending vaults of as many assets as possible. This time, hacker was able to leave with $130 million of crypto tokens. This exploit left other major Ethereum dApps like Aave and Yearn fighting and wondering whether their contract has the same vulnerability. The very core of Ethereum model creates a scenario when a smart contract developer launching a contract cannot have definitive use cases of the endpoint. This leaves a huge security bug and uncertainty if assets can be safe in DeFi. This is the very same problem that Cardano is trying to solve with EUTXO and Haskell-based smart contracts. As mentioned previously, there is $100 billion locked in Ethereum-based DeFi. Ordinary people want to make 5% plus interest on their crypto assets and be safe from exploits in the centralized world. DeFi still is in its primitive stage, so errors are expected. But maybe storing valuable assets in a system that can be exploited is not the way? Maybe DeFi indeed should be safe and Cardano is the way for DeFi? And here I covered Ethereum DeFi. We are building a series of short integrated videos, so subscribe to our channel on YouTube. Also join our community on Twitter, Telegram, and Medium.